Well, saving money, losing weight, staying healthy during a pandemic flu season, those are the worries of many.
And we are worried about those things, too. So Larry, Brian, and I are inviting you to get fit with Team KMBC. Join us for workouts, recipes, and how to eat healthy on a budget. And that's where we begin tonight. Healthy shopping that won't break the bank.
Now this can feed a whole family.
Meet Team KMBC coach Mitzi Dulan. She took us shopping at a local Hy-Vee to prove you can boost your immune system, lose weight, and afford healthy food. Her first piece of advice, stay within the perimeter of the store. We started in the fresh produce aisle.
These would be great for you and Larry and Brian to cut up and have some that you munch on in the evening. Another great thing to have on hand are avocados. Do you like them?
Love them. I love them.
These are great to put on sandwiches in place of mayonnaise. So you can get one cup of berries for only 60 calories. So this is a great, sweet, nutritious snack.
Next, the meat counter, where you can find a pound of fish for $4.99, and there's another reason to load up here.
Protein is also really important, Laura, to keep your immune system strong and healthy. And this is, again, we're staying in the perimeter of the store, and that's where I want you to spend most of your money.
After that, the dairy aisle.
A half cup of this cottage cheese, you get 12 grams of protein. So this is a cheap source of protein as well. Laura, another great thing to have on hand is Greek yogurt. Now, I'm a huge fan of Greek yogurt because it is really high in protein and low in sugar.
Mitzi says if you can't buy fresh vegetables, buy frozen, not canned, with two exceptions.
Canned tomatoes and canned beans are what you should definitely look for in the canned area of the grocery store.
A low-fat, healthy shopping trip on a budget, $125 for a family of four.
And that is almost about 2 weeks of food for a family of four. You may have to go back for a little more bread and a little more milk. Now, Mitzi suggests we write down every morsel of food we eat, which is kind of scary.
Yeah.
Stay away from alcohol for the first 2 weeks and choose foods that aren't full of artificial ingredients. So here are my goals for the month. I want to lose 8 pounds, 8 inches off my waist, and 3% body fat. Here's Mitzi's strategy for me. Eat protein at every meal and record my food intake so I can really see what I'm eating. Larry?
I want to lose 5 to 10 pounds, 2 inches off my waist, and overall just feel healthier. And here's Mitzi's strategy for me. Eat a quick and easy breakfast every morning, a bowl of cereal, oatmeal, or energy bar. If I need to eat when I get home at 11 o'clock, eat a low-calorie snack like fruit, yogurt, or 30 pistachios, right?
That'll work. Now, my goals are a little different. My main focus is getting my diabetes under control. So I need to avoid all juices, which is painful, drink plenty of water. Okay. Mitzi also wants me to bring dinner to work at least 2 times a week instead of going out. And so those are her roadmaps that she has for
me. I'll try some of the recipes, and I'll bring them in. The three of us can share them together.